I'm Sayed Mohsin Sadat. I'm from Afghanistan, and I work in a central bank as a deputy director general for the financial supervision department. And specifically, I'm heading the division for the non-banking financial institutions.
Interesting. So you all traveled to attend the AFI conference.
Yeah.
What was your take?
Oh, this has, AFI has always been an amazing platform for knowledge sharing, to understand what's going on, and especially about the concept of financial inclusion, which you know is a very important concept, and it's very important for the access to finance, leverage to poverty, and...
What doesn't the world know about Afghanistan in that regard?
But yeah, that's why we are here, to represent our country, to tell the world about what's going on in Afghanistan. Afghanistan is a very young in this sense of the financial sector, you can say, the modern financial sector. Banking is not so mature or spread out through the country. As we know, we have lots of challenges of war and stability, political stabilities. But at the same time, we have great opportunities for technology or digital payments, like mobile banking, mobile payments, or any finance through technology. Because I can give you some rough data that 90% of the area is being covered to the covered by the mobile services.
Wow.
And almost above 70% of the people are using smartphones. So that creates the opportunity for people around the world to come and grab that opportunity so platform is already there. So that need to be explored by the finance companies or the fintech companies, which could mutually benefit Afghanistan and that company. So I think,
and
like,
how are they sensitive? This, because the theme this part this year was about women and youth.
Yeah.
And in Afghanistan, how is the situation?
The same. I would say that we have a very young generation, and at the same time, you can say, like, it's like almost 49 or 48% of the population is women, which has been deprived from the finance, access to finance. Similarly, youth is into technology. So I see that women and youth in Afghanistan, or you can see a very good opportunity on market to be captured on. And at the same time, we as a central banker, or we as the people who are obliged to help the economy, grow the economy through the development of the financial sector, we see the opportunity, or we see there's a gap to be fulfilled, you know, through any mean that we can have access them to finance, women and youth. Since we don't have proper stability and political and like peace stability over there, so what we would like to have is that maybe it's difficult for most of the financial companies to go and land there physically, but at the same time, through technology, which is almost a non-physical existence throughout the country, and can grab the opportunity. There's a opportunity for the technological company, because since now, nobody's deprived from technology, nobody's deprived from the phone and mobile phones. So I think there's a, I see that way, that if you go with a minimum, you know, investment through use of technology, you can be very successful in such countries like we are. Like,
interesting. Yeah. So you had something to take from this conference as well?
Yeah, exactly. Like, we have many examples from South America. We have examples from Africa, like Kenya. Kenya have been very successful spreading financial inclusion through mobile banking, mobile money, or e-money. Mm-hmm. So that we have been considering what is their approach, what's their framework, so that we can also adopt in our scenario as well. So that how Kenya was successful that to spread financial inclusion through mobile. So, and we have, as I say, like 90% of the areas covered through the mobile. So there's a gap. And there's a model that the African country has adopted, and they were very successful. So we can also do the same.
Interesting. You said this is the second country in Africa you've been to.
Yep.
Every time you, like, this is the second time when you come to Africa,
yeah.
This is a completely different world.
Oh, like, I was, to be honest, personally, it always was my dream to visit Africa. And only we used to have see it on TV, but we don't have any opportunity or chances.
Have you seen anything that seemed like a myth, but it is real?
To be honest, I don't want to say it, but I was thinking that Africa would be like so messed up and like not so clean, and like people would be not friendly. But it's totally opposite. And I just want to convey through this platform to the world that this is we should not believe in myths, and we can only believe it when we experience it by ourselves. Amazing people, amazing country. I love it being here. Hopefully I'll be here again.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir.